ओके मैम, ओके मैम।
What your teacher is saying? Can you guess what it is? Children, your teacher is asking to sit silent.
Butterfly.
Teacher is asking to sit silent. Okay.
God will recognize.
Under.
Your teacher is asking you to sit silent. Okay.
Okay, ma'am.
This is the symbol used for that.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am.
So this is a way of saying without speaking. I am not speaking, but just through my action, I am asking you to sit silent. You understood, right?
Okay, ma'am. We understood.
Before going to the lesson, children, listen to these instructions. You are asked to sit silent. Okay? You need not respond. Before going to the lesson, you are supposed to sit properly and be attentive. Okay, maintain silence and cooperate for the smooth conduct of the class. You are not supposed to speak as you like. Don't write on the computers or phone screen. Just now I observed few of you writing on the phone screen. You know who it is. Children, if you want to be mischievous and to be known to everyone like that, do like that. So never do such scribbles on the computer screen or phone screen. It will be disturbing others also. In a way, you are not listening, you are not allowing others also to listen. So that is not good thing, is it not? So those who did like that, stay away for yourself.
And yes, ma'am.
Never do like that. Follow the instructions given. See that you are the only participant and you are quiet so that there won't be any disturbance to the class. Even if anyone else, they have to be silent. There should not be any sounds in your room. So that will stop others to listen the class. Okay, children?
Okay, ma'am.
Then don't shout, yes, teacher, no, teacher, okay, teacher. Like that, don't shout. So if imagine all of you like that, then it will be a great disturbance to the class, is it not? Others listen. All of you would not listen if you do like that. So you have to help yourself and you have to help your friends also. So don't make noise. If at all any problem, it is a problem to everyone. I tell only few of you to tell if at all any problem. Those can tell, others should not speak. Okay, children, this is for the sake of smooth conduct of the class. If you sit silent like that, you can listen whatever I am saying and you can understand whatever being taught. So help yourself and help others. Children, I am observing some of you moving away from the screen. It is not good. You have to sit silent and then only you can understand the lesson. Okay? Children, we were studying sign language, saying without speaking in the last class. You just listen what I'm telling. I give you time. In that time, you can ask all your doubts. That time, I will clarify. Because we are not sitting at one place, we have to cooperate with each other. Language. You know language, is it not? Why do you need language? We want language to communicate others, to tell others. What do you want to tell others? You want to tell something what you want. What is your requirement? You will ask your father or mother. I want this dress. Like that, you ask your desires. Whatever you want to say others, you will say through language. So that language is developed for that sake. Shahid, don't do that. Then, language is very much important, children. Through language, you can tell others your desires, your feelings, your requirements, etc. So, if you don't tell anyone, you will not get what you want. Is it not? And then, children, sometimes we tell through symbols. Sometimes, instead of words, silence will speak a lot. Already I told you once, silence, speech is silver, silence is gold. So sometimes speaking in silence will be more effective. The other
page number.
Who is asking page number, Rishi? Don't do that. I will tell you how to look into the textbook. I will tell you. Maintain silence. The instructions will be given to you. So, means through actions, through facial expressions, through our posture, we will gather sometimes. I give some one example. Suppose class is very noisy. What the teacher does? Teacher comes and tells like this. Teacher won't speak anything. Teacher tells like this. So immediately your attention is diverted. You will, as soon as you observe the teacher like this, you become silent. Right? So the symbols, the signs speak a lot. That also can convey message to others. So this type of language is called sign language. So children, for our sake, let us have some signs for today's class. Hey, look, observe what you are saying. Teacher is showing like this. That means you have to listen or follow the instruction given by the teacher. So whenever teacher shows like this, it is a symbol. You have to listen to the instruction given. Next. I am observing sounds from your house. Children, I am showing like this. This is, what is the symbol of this? The class 3A has to answer. That is, one of you from class 3A will answer only when I show this symbol. Next. If I show like this, class 3B will answer. Children, what are you doing? Dhruvesh. 3B has to answer if it is like this. I am not raising those things, children. I will know who is doing that. I will announce at the end of the class. Given the instruction, you are not following. Suppose if I show like this, this is anyone from class 3C should answer. So this is the symbolic language or sign language we developed for the sake of our class. For today's, I'm taking few people. From 3A, Akshara has to answer. Akshara, are you present? Okay. Aditya?
Yes, ma'am.
Aditya will answer. From 3B, Arhan will answer. Isa Arhan. 3C, Amulya. Is Amulya present? Say yes or no.
Yes, ma'am.
So you will answer. So according to the symbols only you will be answering.
Yes, ma'am.
No, yes, no more. Then children, look here. What is written there? We tell others without speaking by making use of our gestures. That means our eyes, our eyebrows speaks. Our body movements, we do like this, so our body moves, head move, hands, legs, so our body measures, so these are called body movements, facial expressions, past class I showed you happy face, sad face, like that. So these kind of gestures, through these gestures, we speak without saying anything. So this kind of language is called sign language. Now, let us identify some action words using sign language. Okay? Now, teacher showed like this. That means, who has to answer? Aditya has to answer. Still some scribblings I am finding. Children, I come to know who are doing that. I am not erasing them. It will be on their names. Children, what teacher is doing? Aditya, what is teacher doing?
Reading.
What action is reading? Oh, very good. Very good. Teacher is
reading.
So, you are enacting like reading a book. Now, let us go to the next action.
Writing.
Very good. Very good. I am observing others speaking. Only Aditya has to answer.
Right.
I come to know, you are all understanding. I come to know. Don't speak out like that. Next action, let us see, children.
Looking.
Yes, what is the teacher doing now?
Singing, ma'am.
Singing, very nice.
Singing, ma'am.
Ah, pulling, very good. Very good. You are all good children.
Pulling, ma'am.
You are all intelligent children, but children don't disturb the class. What is for your sake only, children? Now, let us identify some occupations using sign language. Now, Arhan will answer from class 3B. Teacher is going like this now. Arhan has to answer. Okay? Now, what is the occupation you have to identify? Looking at the action, you have to tell who is the
dancer.
Who is that person? Arhan, who is that person? Who is that? Who is that?
Yes,
ma'am. Who is that? Doctor. Is doctor. So doctor is a noble profession, children. Next, let us see. Children, I am observing sounds. I don't like that. I will stop the lesson if you do like that.
Dance.
I told you your room should be quiet. No one in the room is
dancing.
Dancing, ma'am.
So dancing. These are all called dancers. These are all called
dancers.
I asked you not to
dancing, ma'am.
I asked you not to
speak.
Shall I stop, children? Shall I stop, children? Your parents are also talking? Your parents are also talking, children. I will stop the class if you do like that. Children, now I want to introduce an interesting game. This game is called Dumb Charades. This game is called Dumb Charades. Okay. So for every game, there will be rules, children. What are the rules for this game? This is a very interesting game. Anywhere, anyone can play.
Yes.
Okay. Let us see what is the rules of this game, how this game is played. So this game is, what is the name of this game? Dumb Charades. So, dumb charades is a word guessing game.
Miss dumb charades.
I didn't ask you to read out, children. Dumb charades is a word guessing game. So, you have to guess the word. How to guess the word and all, I will tell you. There will be two or more number of teams. Two teams are more than two teams. Here you can observe team A, team B. Okay? Team A is here. Team B is here. So here only two teams. There may be more number of teams also. And each number will be few people. It will be the same number in each group. Group 3, 1 group 4, it can be like that. It is based on the interest. Children, you are all doing annotations on the screen. I'm noting down who are all doing that. It is not right. And then children, it is not good. You should not do like that. You are disturbing your friends also in doing so. What enjoyment you get like that? Are you good children or not? Don't you understand that much?
Yes, ma'am.
Shall I tell your names who are doing? So there will be two teams here. Team A. The same in each team, the same number need not be there. So how it continues? Let us see.
అర్థం చేసుకో మాట్లాడి
Now, in two teams, team B gives a slip to a member of team A. Children, here you are finding a bowl consisting of paper slips. So in the paper slips, a word will be written and it is closed. So you can see the word. Team B will select one slip and give that slip to the member of team A. So from team A, this person has come. To him, these team B people gave one slip. What this person will do? He will open the slip and read what is written on that slip. Okay. Suppose some doctor, it is written in the word. The slip, the word doctor is written. Then he has to close the slip and then he has to act like a doctor. And when he acts like something, these team A, remaining team A people are there, now they have to guess what is that word. So if they guess the correct word, doctor, then, now just now you have guessed that through actions, likewise. If this team A can guess the word, team A gets point. If they don't guess the word, they don't get the point. That is the game. So, after team A, that member should ask for the word in the slip.
Good morning, teacher.
And if team A gets the correct word, it gets a point. The next team continues. Okay. Next team continues.
Good morning, teacher.
Who is that saying good morning, good morning? Children, because of that, the time is running out.
Wait a minute,
Children, are you able to see? Now, are you able to see?
Yes, ma'am. Okay.
See, if you speak like that, the time is running out. I am not able to tell what I wanted to do. Okay. So in this way, the teams scored more will be the winner. Points who scores, that will be the winner. Children, I will share you.
So, that link
you see what is there in that. Children, most of us can hear and speak, but there are some people who can not hear, who cannot speak. So this person cannot hear. He is called deaf. Okay? He cannot hear. This person cannot speak. He cannot speak. So this person is called dumb. Those who can hear, mostly they will be dumb. So these two together we call deaf person. So deaf person cannot hear, he cannot speak. How they understand? Through the lip movements. When we speak, the lip movements will be there, is it not? So for the words we are speaking, our lips will move. Based on the lip movement, they understand things. Okay?
So they are
through actions. Through actions, they understand. So, children, I'm giving a clipping here. So, for these kind of deaf people, news is read separately with the sign language. Then that link also I will send you. That news you observe. How these people are shown, how they understand the news on TV. So, this is the Doordarshan. Doordarshan news is read for these kind of people, deaf people. Okay, children?
Yes.
Next. Still again, you are not. And children, you look at a girl here. Are you able to see her? One girl sitting in the chair. So, what is the importance of this girl? Who is this girl? Her name is called Helen Keller. Her name is called Helen Keller. So she is at the age of 19 months. She got sick. She got severe fever. And suddenly she lost her eyes. She could not see. She could not hear. She became deaf at the age of 19 months, children, not even 2 years. So what she did, even in that disgrace also, she was very courageous. She never lost her courage. So what she did, by the age of 7, she developed some home signs, say 60 home signs, that is symbols like we are using the symbols now, is it not? Stopping, saying, like that. So she developed 60 home signs to communicate with her family. 60 types of symbols. Through symbols, she used to communicate with her family. And then, one more thing, children. Now, her eyes are not working, her ears are not working. So the two major sense organs are not working. We can see only through our eyes. Children, imagine yourself. Closing your eyes, how long you can stay? Can you sit for 1 hour? 1 day? The whole day, can you sit without seeing? Closing your eyes? Is it possible? Is it possible for you? No.
No, ma'am.
See, this poor girl, she has to stay throughout her life without seeing, without speaking, just because she got some sickness. That is not her fault. Whatever it is, she was not crying for her deficiency. What she did, you just observe. Eller could identify things with the feel of touch. Slowly, she mastered in the Braille script and could read and write in that. So children, beside Keller, one more lady is sitting here. Do you know who it is? It is her teacher. So what her teacher did, on Helen's hand, she poured water. So water when it is poured, it touches the hand. So through the touch, it showed, teacher told, it is water. It is water. Like that, with a touch, she was made to understand the words. And then, slowly she mastered in the Braille script. The Braille script is specially designed for blind people. Okay? So, this Helen Keller could write and read in that script. After that, she mastered and then she published 12 books. She wrote 12 books. Is it? When you get some command, then you can write things, write about something. She wrote 12 books and many articles. So she was such a great person. She did try for her deficiency, but she overcame from that deficiency and she achieved something. She learned the Braille script and she learned the lessons and then she wrote books. She became a famous writer. There are many institutions on her name, many libraries on her name, Helen Keller's name. And then you can see children, a coin here on Helen Keller's name. So children, you have to be naughty. You understand? You should become great like such persons. One more thing I want to tell children. Even though she is blind, she could not hear. She achieved that great heights. She got respect in the society. But observe yourself, children. You are all having all organs functioning well. You are physically fit and mentally fit. So you should be grateful. You should be grateful to your parents for that. Your parents gave birth to you. You are having all organs functioning. So you pay respect, thanks to your parent. Because of your parent, you are healthy. And one more thing, children, saying thanks, what you have to just to say thanks, it is okay. No, for parents, you should not tell like that. Your parents have desires. They have dreams about you. They wanted you to become a doctor, an engineer, or scientist, or a pilot, like that, so many dreams they have. So you have to know those dreams and you have to fulfill those dreams. Last time I talked about some Kalyan Raman, is it not? So even though he doesn't have anything, even though he lived a poor life, he became a great engineer. So nothing should be a barrier for that. You have to achieve and you have to fulfill your parents' dreams.